Well, then, just in response to that, it would be really useful if you, when you spoke to the person who rules the committee section there, to actually ask the question about what work is undertaken. Because if you also appreciate that there's different levels of SRA across the council, all based on the responsibilities and the work that people do. The committee don't just turn up and have an agenda and then debate it. They do a lot of work, a lot of hard work, that actually then is passed into the committee structure or into that particular meeting. So I would suggest that's done at first. But if we were to take that response that you're suggesting to this, then let's take it to every committee and every special responsibility allowance across the whole council and indeed across the whole city region.
We've had two speeches in favour. Anybody else wish to speak on the amendment? In that case, can we move straight to the vote on the amendment? Those in favour of the amendment? Those against the amendment? The vote was for 7 votes against 79, 2 abstentions, so the amendment is lost. Can we further amendment?
Can I, my Lord Mayor, move just that the point 1A be deferred, and if I may speak to that very briefly. We did have a very fair and very balanced
debate. Can I just ask you before you carry on, this second event, what do you mean?
We did have a very fair and balanced debate, and I don't think we necessarily all had a conclusion when we started that debate. But the point I still feel very uncomfortable about is, even with the information provided, if I use the example, a ward councillor on average in this council will attend 2 nation committees, sometimes some subcommittees working badly, possibly neighbourhood work. That is evaluated at the moment at 10.5k or thereabouts. That will do 2 committees. I can't see the proportionality of workload. And that's the point. And we did ask for some information before we came to you today. If a member's going to the Transport Committee, they're paying half of the amount we will get within the chamber, including the 2 committees, we move on average, that is on average, work on, plus the ward work, plus the neighbour work. A chairman of this council committee, I know there's some committees that are more rigorous than chairperson. More rigorous than that, and I accept that. And it's always hard to hit a benchmark. We'll be paid approximately £5,000-6,000 more than a full member. This chairmanship is paid £24,500 more. And I can't see from the schedule, because we did ask for the schedule, to see if that's proportionate. So if I voted for the measure, I feel personally I'll be compounding an imbalance. We have raised this, I have actually spoken to the independent panel and said frequently I didn't feel that the scale of SRAs and board members were balanced at all, were out of kilter. And however many times we've said it, there hasn't been a review. So I'm going to be quite candid. No disrespect to the chairman, but I'm asking all the times I've asked inquiries about transport, he's been more helpful. So it's not a real personal comment. It is just, I think, we've been compounding an imbalance. And we have often been told a review will take place. I've actually gone to the panel sometimes when it's not quite a metro period, which is inconvenient, and actually spoken first hand. Having chaired the meeting, I didn't think that represented a 50% rule workload, and I would as a normal word councillor. So I think it's about time we do need a fundamental review, and we do a more factual basis, and that hasn't been forthcoming for some time.
But anybody else want to speak on the amendment? No? Okay, can we move?
You want to come back in, Jim?
Okay.
I don't know, it's a big comment to say, whilst at the end of the day, we're all our opinions on what. I can tell you that in my view, the way that the current chair of the authority goes, deserves far more than the responsibility allowance that he receives. However, I accept the comments that you make, but I don't know how the delay is going to. Are you asking him to be fair? I'm not convinced that it's going to achieve anything. You're still going to have the opportunity to make representations about that particular thing to the review. I'm not convinced that it's going to achieve anything. You ask him to be fair. So on that basis, I would ask the council to reject the request.
Can we move to the vote? This is on the amendment, first of all. Those in favour of the amendment? I think we've got six there. Those against the amendment? I would say it clearly lost, but... we've really got to wait for the count on this. Clearly lost. So we move the amendment, now we have to move the actual motion. So are we for? Say voting? Say voting. Everybody's happy with that, the motion's carried. Moving on to item 10, nominations of local authority representative, Governors Councillor Small.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. I move the recommendation set out on pages 71 to 72 of the Council agenda to be approved.
Is that agreed? Come on, be enthusiastic. Is that agreed? Thank you. Right, very quickly on the motion, we're doing well so far. Let's try.
Can I make a suggestion and ask the council's indulgence and approval? Is that if we move the Grenfell motion and the tired motion forward, because people are here, and I'm happy to actually move mine to the back or whatever, if the council would agree.
I'm certainly happy with that. Everybody agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I ask Laura Robertson-Collins to move that particular motion? And then I'm going to call Councillor Hart.
Many thanks, Lord Mayor. Lord Mayor, we're all extremely shocked, upset and angry about the terrible tragedy that happened in London at the Grenfell Tower. I've heard tonight from our colleague in the fire service about the very real impact that's had on their work and on the demands on that service and the stress that's put everybody under. We don't yet know fully what happens with regards to the Grenfell Tower specifically, but most worryingly, it seems that in the main, the building was in compliance with the current regulation. That is extremely worrying because, as the Mayor mentioned before, after both petitioners have spoken, it shows that the level of regulation enforcement, particularly with regard to design, of fire safety and rented accommodation is simply not adequate. So, Lord Mayor, the motion before us says this council has had concerns for a long time that the demands of developers and landlords have been prioritised at the expense of residents and tenants with regard to safety, fire safety, building control. So, it's very important that we express our concerns, this council's concerns, to the government nationally. And as the points in the motion say, I think there was an addendum to the motion, is that added? I've got the addendum, by the way. Anyone's going to ask me that. As the motion says, including the addendum that Councillor Hannah is going to add, it's important we express all those concerns listed on that motion to the government, and that we write to the ministers and to our own MPs in this city to make clear our views from this council. But it's also important that we do everything possible as a council within our powers to ensure we fully use all the building control regulations that are possible. I've stood in this chamber on several occasions over the last 6 years to call for action to limit the rampant development and landlordism that we've seen in the city and nationally. And I know that many, if not all, colleagues in this chamber share the concerns and my frustration that the lack of input local councils can have on planning and development affecting our residents. Not a week goes by in Greenbank Ward without another house of multiple occupation being created. That's often done by extending a small property, which means they get away with doing it under permitted development. It doesn't even have to have a planning application. This worryingly often involves converting loft space into living space for which the building was not designed, surely a fire risk. Only last month, a man had to escape across rooftops in Langdale Road in our ward after a fire was deliberately set on fire at the ground floor of their house. Fortunately, in that instance, that person was able-bodied and they have survived to tell the tale and they're okay. But they had to escape across roofs from a second floor building that wasn't designed to have people living on the second floor. Very much welcome the interventions that we've seen by this council since we've had Labour's administration. And often they've been in the face of the Tory government's opposition. Landlord licensing stands as something that this council can be very proud of. But surely the time has arrived when the balance of building control can revert back to us as a council and as residents and councils actually having some control over that, particularly with regard to fire safety. So despite what the free marketeers may believe, there is no such thing as too much health and safety legislation.
Note for Councillor Hanratty had an amendment that was accepted there. Is that right, Councillor Collins?
Yes,